Okay, my dear children of class 11 science, we will now derive an expression of work done by an ideal gas in isothermal expansion. Now children, you learn about isothermal process. Okay, now in isothermal process, the gas can be expanded. The gas has expansion or gas has a compression. Now gas as a system, okay, can have an expansion or it can have a compression. Okay, but let me just tell you that whenever there is expansion of gas or compression of gas under isothermal expansion, the work is done by the gas or work is done on the gas, which means work is done on by the system or work is done on the system. Okay, but what type of gas we take? Ideal gas. So ideal gas is also known as what gas? As I said, perfect gas. Perfect gas. Okay, now I consider there is a gas called ideal gas, and I consider that there is what? There is n mole. So I'll not take one mole, but I'll take n moles of ideal gas. Now this n can be of any value. It can be 2 mole also, it can be 3 mole, it can be 10 mole, any mole. But I just consider that there is n mole of what? Ideal gas. Okay. Taken in a what? Gas which is taken in a cylinder. Gas taken. Okay, let me just write down taken in a cylinder. Okay, taken in a cylinder having perfectly what? Conducting material. Perfectly conducting what? Material. That means the cylinder as a surrounding is made up of perfectly conducting materials. Okay, so when this gas is taken in this perfectly conducting material, then we do the expansion of the gas. Now in order to get the expansion of gas, the volume changes. Volume increases means there is expansion of gas, and when there is expansion of gas from certain volume to other volume, definitely the work is done by the what? Gas. Okay, so when isothermal expansion takes place in ideal gas, as I said, the work is done by the what? Gas. So I write down for isothermal expansion. Now for isothermal expansion, okay, work is done by the gas. The work is done by the gas means work is done by the system. Work is done by the what? System. Okay, now for that I already consider there is n mole of what? Ideal gas. Okay, and this gas must be taken at constant temperature. Must be at constant temperature, because you know what is the important condition for isothermal process to take place? This process takes place only at what temperature? Constant temperature. So temperature must remain what? Constant. And under this case, I consider that the volume of the gas changes from V1. Now this gas volume, V1 means initial volume. I consider initial volume. And the gas get expand from initial volume V1 to final volume. That volume is, I consider as V2. So V2 is the what volume? Final volume. So children, the condition which I am taking is the gas when have an expansion is expanded from initial volume V1 to final volume what? V2. Okay, so in order to get the volume to be expanded from V1 to V2, definitely the work is done by the what? Gas. Work is done by the what? Gas. And to calculate the work done by the gas, also thermodynamic system, I write down the formula. The formula is work done by the gas is given by W, and it is equals to integration. Now this is the sign I am using, children, because your volume is expanding from V1 to V2. So this is the two limit of volume in which the gas is get expanded. So in order to calculate the total work done to increase the volume from V1 to V2, we use this sign of integration. Okay, and the work done by the gas, W equals to integration of V1 to V2. And this work done by the gas as a thermodynamic system is given as pressure into change in volume, PdV. And this dB is very small change in volume. But to calculate the total change in volume from V1 to V2, the total work is done by the gas, and that work done is W. That's why, children, total work done by the gas to change the volume from V1 to V2 is measured by this formula. So this is the formula we use. So W equals to integration of V1 to V2 PdV. Whereas this sign is called integration, and this is the lower limit and this is the upper limit. Okay, now this P means the pressure, and this is the pressure of the gas at an instant of time, at an instant. That means, because in isothermal expansion only the temperature will not change, the pressure will change and the volume is also changing. Because change in volume, the pressure also changes. But this pressure is the pressure at any instant, at any amount of volume. Okay, now in order to calculate the work done, as you know, that isothermal expansion process follow what? Boyle's law. And when it follow Boyle's law, the relation between pressure and volume and even the temperature is given by the gas equation. And this gas equation is called ideal gas equation. And children, the expression, the detailed explanation of ideal gas equation, you learn in the next year too, in the next unit. Okay. Now for ideal gas equation, I write for n mole of the gas. How many moles? N mole of gas is given by PB equals to nRT. Children, this relation you'll be learning in the next YouTube, next unit. So PB equals to nRT. P means the pressure, B is the volume, N is the number of moles of the gas, R is the molar gas constant, and T is the temperature. So what I do, I eliminate P. So to eliminate P and to calculate this work done in terms of time, temperature, and to do integrate with volume, I make P as the subject. So children, if I make P as the subject from ideal gas equation, P equals to nRT by P. Now this value of P I substitute in this relation. Okay, let me just give this equation number 1. If I substitute this P in equation 1, so you see what will be the expression. W equals to integration of B1 to B2. P means nRT by B and dB. So children, out here, to derive the expression of work done by the gas, we are following exactly calculus, integration. Okay. Now, in this integration, N, R and T are constant. This whole quantity is constant. Means N is the number of mole, number is simply constant, R is also constant, temperature is also constant under isothermal process. So, I'll take out this from the integration, nRT out from the integration. So, B1 to B2, now this is dB by B. Now children, this is the integration of B1 to B2, dB by B. Now in calculus, there is a formula of this integration. So I'm writing the formula at the side. Dx of x, integration of dx of what? X. And the formula is, integration of dx of x is always given by log x. Log what? X. And this log x of always of base e. So children, look at the formula. Integration of dx by x is always given by a formula, that is log x is the variable with base e. So your x is equivalent to b. Okay, so let me just expand. So nRT, I write on log of b. See, x means b, so log of b with base e. But I have done the integration, but there are the limit in the integration, b1 and b2. So after integration, put bracket and write b2 upper limit and B1 low limit. So W equals to nRT with log B with base E, upper limit B2 and lower limit what? B1. And you know there is a case of expansion of this limit, and the expansion always upper limit minus lower limit. B is the variable which is B2 upper limit minus B is the variable which is B1 which is lower limit. So how to expand? I write on nRT log, okay, I write in bracket log with base e b2 upper limit minus log of base e with b is b1 lower limit. So w equals nRT log of e with b2 minus log of e b1. Now there is a formula in logarithm, I think you learn in class 9 also logarithm, and the formula is, okay, let me just write it at the break. Log m minus log n is equals to log m by n. See, this is the formula. Log m minus log n equals to log m by n. So this is just like similar way. So nRT log of e b2 by b1. See, look at it. nRT log of base e with b2 by b1. So this is also the expression of work done by the ideal gas under isothermal expansion. See, we are dealing with the expansion of the gas, where B2 is greater than B1. B2 is greater than what? B1. Okay. But children, you know that this isothermal process follows which law? Boyle's law. So the same work done can be expressed in terms of pressure also, and can in terms of pressure also. Yes. So I write down since from which law? Boyle's law. So isothermal process follows which law? Boyle's law. That's why I write down the relation that P1 B1 equals to P2 B2. Yes, you have learned this one. Product of P1 and B1 equals to P2 B2. Now I write down P1 by this P2 will go in the denominator, B2, and this B1 will go in the denominator. So just making B2 and B1 as the subject. So B2 by B1 is nothing but P1 by P2. Now this B2 by B1 I replace by P1 by P2 in this relation. So now see what happened. W equals to nRT with log of P1 by P2 with base E. So look at the expression of work done by ideal gas. W equals to nRT log of base E with P1 by what? P2. Okay. Now, but this law work done which we have expressed in terms of log of base E, but the same log can be converted into log of base 10. Okay. Now the question arises, how to convert log of base E to log of base 10? And for that is in the logarithm chapter. Okay, you have learned that log of any variable like x with base e can be converted to log of that variable with base 10 by this factor. So we need to multiply by 2.3026. So log of x with base e is equal to 2.3026 log of x with base 10. So I follow this relation. So the relation is now work done. As you know, work done equals to nRT. Okay, nRT with log of E with B2 by B1. This is the relation that we have derived. So this work done now I convert from base E to base 10. So this quantity now is equivalent to X. So can I write exactly in the similar manner? I write down this as 2.3026. Okay, 2.3026, and there is already nRT with log of, now E I'll not write base 10, I write on base 10, and this is B2 by B1. So look at the expression. I mean, same work done by the ideal gas, but in terms of base log of base 10 is given by this. And we use this formula to measure the work done by an ideal gas. But this is in terms of volume. Similar, I write on in terms of pressure also. 2.3026 nRT with log of base 10 with power P1 by P2 in terms of pressure also. So these are the two expressions of work done by the ideal gas under isothermal expansion in terms of volume and in terms of pressure. As you know that as the gas expand, as I said already, B2 is greater than B1. If B2 is greater than B1, then definitely the ratio B2 by B1 is greater than 1. Means this quantity will be greater than 1. Okay. Under this case, this work done, which we calculate, this particular work done, that means this work done is positive. So when work is done by the ideal gas under isothermal expansion, that work done is positive. Because this work done in terms of volume, which we have expressed, so that this quantity of log will be positive, means this whole quantity become positive. That's why work will be positive. Okay, this means that the work done by the work is done by the what gas when B2 is greater than what B1. So under isothermal expansion, work is always done by the gas. But the reverse process is also true. Now for compression, yes, it can be the case of compression. For compression of gas, B2 will be less than B1. Final volume will be less than initial volume. So under this case, what happened? The relation B2 by B1 will be less than 1. And B2 by B1 less than 1 will be, which is negative. Okay, under this case, what happened? This logarithm will be negative. Log of 10, B2 by B1 will be what? Negative. That means this quantity, which is negative, means work is also what? Negative. Work done is also what? Negative. Work done is also what? Negative. Which means when work done is negative, when B2 is less than B1, that is under isothermal compression. So this means that work is done on the gas. The work is done on the what? Gas. Means when work is done on the gas, that work done is always negative. Work done on the gas. So children, this part you need to keep in mind, because as you know that work done can be positive, it can be negative. But for expansion of gas, work done is always positive. For compression of gas, work done is always negative. Okay, so this is the detailed explanation and the expression of work done by an ideal gas in isothermal expansion. So in the next YouTube video, we do work done by ideal gas but in adiabatic expansion.